The season of Advent bids us prepare ourselves both for the celebration of Christ's nativity and also for the day when he shall come to judge the hearts of us all. So, in sorrow and penitence, let us confess our failures and shortcomings and renew in ourselves the vision of God's perfect kingdom, which is the end of all our strivings and the consummation of God's loving purposes for us. In word and music, we will give voice to the hope set forth in the scriptures that God's kingdom will come, and with John the Baptist and the Blessed Virgin Mary, we will prepare for its coming, celebrating its dawning in the birth, life, and death of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. But first, let us pray for those who, by reason of adversity, yearn especially for its coming, the hungry and the homeless, the sick and the sorrowful, the lonely and the unloved, those who sit in the darkness of despair or walk in the shadow of death. Let us pray for the leaders of the nations and for all who strive for the establishment of justice, righteousness, and peace. And that it may bear witness to this hope in a world divided by wrath and sorrow, let us pray for the well-being and unity of Christ's body, the Church. Let us then pray for the coming of God's kingdom in the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our Father, who art in
heaven,
thank you.
reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. God commissions Isaiah to be the prophet of the Advent. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphims. Each one had six wings. With twain he covered his face, and with twain he covered his feet, and with twain he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the posts of the door moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Then said I, Woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs from off the altar. And he laid it upon my mouth and said, Lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thine iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. Also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then said I, Here am I, send me. And he said, Go and tell this people, Hear ye indeed, but understand not, and see ye indeed, but perceive not. Make the heart of this people fat, and make their ears heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and convert, and be healed. Then said I, Lord, how long? And he answered, Until the cities be wasted without inhabitant, and the houses without man, and the land be utterly desolate. And the Lord have removed men far away, and there be a great forsaking in the midst of the land. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thanks.
Thank you.
said your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem, and cry unto her, that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. For she hath received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. The voice said, cry. And he said, what shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all the goodliness thereof is as of a flower of the field. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, because the Spirit of the Lord bloweth upon it. Surely the people is grass. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Here endeth the second lesson.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. The prophet foretells the coming of the Lord and the increase of his kingdom. Sing and rejoice, O daughter of Zion, for lo, I come, and I dwell in the midst of thee, saith the Lord. And many nations shall be joined to the Lord in that day, and shall be my people. And I will dwell in the midst of thee, and thou shalt know that the Lord of hosts has sent me unto thee. And the Lord shall inherit Judah his portion in the Holy Land, and shall choose Jerusalem again. Be silent, O all flesh, before the Lord, for he is raised up out of his holy habitation. Here endeth the third lesson.
Oh. cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said to her, "Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. Behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end." Then said Mary to the angel, "How shall this be, seeing I do not know that?" The angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God." And Mary said, "Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word." And the angel departed from her. Here endeth the fourth lesson.
Thank you. this wise. When, as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife. That which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Here endeth the fifth lesson.
Oh, salvation of the Lord.
O Lord, who for our sake was of a virgin born, make holy thy people.